Channel, and as you can tell by the title of this video, what we're gonna be talking about, my nipples again. So as you can see, different background. I'm actually in my living room right now, so welcome to my living room, mi casa es su casa. Yeah, I felt like it was time. I've had my nipples pierced for about a month now, almost a month, and I was like, you know, some things have changed and I feel like I need to do this so people know what to expect. I'm gonna talk about some of the products that I used along my healing process, because technically they're still healing, but they don't hurt anymore, so I want to let you know what I've done so that way they don't hurt you anymore. First initial thing, I guess this could be like a do's and don'ts or what to expect type of video as well. So when you get to the tattoo shop or tattoo and piercing place, so when you go into the tattoo and piercing place, they're obviously gonna ask you, what do you want to pierce? You're gonna say, I want my titties pierced, it's fine. And then they're gonna be like, okay. So they take you to the bag. One thing you need to look for is to make sure that everything is coming out of a clean package, and that, you know, just everything is nice and clean and professional. If they're like not using gloves, not sterilizing anything, you might want to get out of there. But they're probably gonna take you back to the room, you know, you're gonna have to take your shirt off. Like, yes, you have to get naked. Well, you don't have to take your shirt off. I didn't take mine off, I just kind of like and had it here, like, still, you know. And then they're going to clean off your nipples and then put the little dots there so they can line it up to make sure that it's straight and to make sure that they're not stabbing you in your areola, because the nipple and the areola I hate myself. The nipple and the areola are two completely different parts of the breasts, but you don't want them stabbing you through the areola, because that apparently has happened before, my piercer told me, and I'm just like, what? The pain on a scale of 1 to 10, I think I said in my video, was like a 5 or a 6. Still the same answer, 5 or a 6. However, the aftercare, my friends, oh my god, the aftercare. Okay, so before I had went and got this pierced, I was looking at some nipple piercing videos, and one of the main things that they were saying in the nipple piercing video was that do not put anything drying on your nipples, because if the wind blows and they get hard or anything like that, it is going to hurt like a mother freaking doodle. Like, you don't know. Like, I didn't have to learn the hard way, but definitely it's just not a fun experience when your nipples start to hurt, so just don't do that. A soap that they did say was a good soap to use and you could use is the Dove Sensitive Soap, and I had already had that. I got a big tub of it, beauty guru-esque, but I got the Dove Sensitive Skin. It's very hydrating, it's high, can I talk today? It's hypoallergenic. It's number one in dermatologists recommended, though. I don't know. They said to use like mild soaps, but like, I don't know. Because when I got my tattoo, fun fact, not from the same place, but when I was 17 and I got my first tattoo on my arm, they told me that I could use like mild like soaps, and I did, and I swear. I think this was like the first or second night that I had my tattoo and I went to go wash it, and the soap like made my arm hurt so bad to the point where I almost passed out. So I don't trust mild antibacterial soaps anymore when it comes to like tattoos and piercings like that. I just, no. I would recommend the Dove soap. Please just get the Dove soap. You'll thank me later. A friend recommended me some of it's the same brand, and I got two different bottles, and I'm kind of glad that I did because they kind of do two different things. But it's the Dermoplast brand, and I had talked about this in my first nipple piercing video. This one is just a pain and itch spray, and this one is a first aid spray for cuts, scrapes, and burns. It prevents infections and relieves pain quickly. And they're both hospital trusted, so you need to make sure that you look for these two right here. I'm trying to like make it to where it's not so bright, but you need to look for these two. So what I do when I get out of the shower, because I always, okay, let's rewind. So the first week that I had my, that I've had my nipples pierced, I washed my nipples twice a day. I would take a shower at night and I would wash it, and I would spray it, I would spray my nipples with this first, and then I would go in and spray it with this, and I would be done. Like, that's fine. And then in the morning I would wake up, get some Q-tips, and then I would like get a Q-tip wet and put a little bit of soap on there and kind of like just clean around the piercing, and then I would rinse them off, and then I would go back in and spray with this first and then this for the first week. But now after that, because they're healed and they're not like bleeding anymore or anything, I only wash them once a day, and that's usually at night, right after I get out of the shower. I obviously wash with my Dove soap, and now instead of doing just those two bottles, I've added in my Thayer's Witch Hazel with aloe vera formula, with rose petals and stuff. It's alcohol free, so it's not going to be very drying on the nipples, and I feel like it just gives like an extra cleansing, I guess. So I'll just like spray it once on my nipples, and then I'll like psh, psh, and then psh, psh, and then I'm done. Ew, I just spit. I am disgusting. Now as far as like what they're doing a month later, this is my right boob. My right one took a little bit longer to like stop bleeding. Like my left one, it was fine. It was like, I'm living life, I'm living large, like everything's fine. But my right one was like going through something. I don't know what was up with it, because like I was cleaning both of them just fine and doing the same thing for each one, so I'm not really sure why it was doing that, but like it kept bleeding and it was weird and it was painful. Now it's completely fine. The only thing that's a little annoying, and they both do this now, but it's normal for them to do this, because my piercer told me, so if yours does this, don't feel like you're alone, like it's fine. But they kind of like crust up, like, you know when you get your ears pierced and you haven't, I don't, taken your earrings out or cleaned them for a while, and then you take them out and they're like, there's that crust stuff on there. that's pretty much what goes on your nipples. So, but it comes right off, like, and it's gonna happen. It's gonna crust for a while, because like I said, I've only had them for a month, so they're not completely healed. Like, they're not infected, they're not green or anything. Just as long as, I would recommend washing them twice a day for the first week, week and a half, and then after that, you know, like, give them a break and only wash them once a day. Because you don't want to overwash your skin, because that will dry them out and that will make your nipples crack, and you don't want crackly ass nipples hurting all the dang time, because that's not fun. The pain went away after, like, honestly, week two. Like, I couldn't feel them anymore. Like, you know they're there, because I'm playing with them, right? I always make sure, like, sometimes throughout the day, like, I'll go and, like, squeeze to make sure both balls are on each end of the piercing, because I've seen some people where, like, the balls fall off, and I'm like, I'm not going and getting these re-pierced if this fucking falls out. Yeah, that is my 1 month update. They're fine. I was a little skeptical. I was a little skeptical about getting them pierced because of the price, but because that place is so popular that them doing $10 piercings, they're not really losing business. They're honestly gaining more business. Like, they gained my business. So, yeah, I would definitely recommend getting them pierced, man. They're like life-changing. So my camera definitely just decided to shut off on me, but I did want to come back and just close out the video. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!